Previously on Inconceivable.
It's a boy, Mr. Lindstrom.
He's not ours. What the hell is this?
Why isn't anyone questioning Dr. Bowers? He did the transfer. Whose eggs did he put inside of me?
You want to talk to me, you do in front of a jury. They should have their license revoked.
We both know you missed something very important. Your mistake may cost your good friend Rachel this business.
I'm not letting you take the bullet for this.
You don't have a choice. If I don't, you'll lose everything.
Reverend and Mrs. Gilly, your blood test came back negative.
We put in 5 embryos.
It's just a matter of when.
What if that never happens?
I need your help. I have a couple, early 40s. They could be ideal candidates for a cytoplasmic transfer.
Risky procedure.
You've done it with success. Don't dismiss these people because you have an issue with me. They need your help.
What happened?
Patrice, you knew what this was. Everything's got an expiration date.
Can a girl have a proper goodbye?
What do we do?
Visiting Doctor's Park?
Well, let me see now. Since you're a guest, you might want to try guest parking. 2 flights down.
Well, if I'm a guest at this party, that makes you the host, so you can clean up.
Hold the elevator.
Excuse me.
Morning.
Morning.
So, looks like things get chilly going up when something stops going down.
You work on that for a while?
No, seriously. Hey, I'm sorry to hear about what happened between you two.
Angel, why don't you save the small talk for when you're collecting urine samples?
Gee, I thought our shift started here at 8.
What's Nurse Molly's problem? Someone force feed her a cracker?
She's still peeved you wouldn't approve her vacation. She was supposed to go on a cruise with her parents.
Her parents? She should be thanking me.
Dan? What's the matter? Dan, what are you doing?
Where are the others?
Excuse me?
From the clinic. Why are you the only one at these negotiations?
I'm the legal counsel for Family Options, Mr. Lindstrom.
Right. Well, tell them hello. You ruined our chances of having a baby. Tell them money isn't going to fix this, for me or for them.
And she said her camera was broken, so we bought her a new one.
Just look at this rope. Is this not the best rope for lying around the house when you're as big as a house?
What did you guys do? I mean, Diane's not even pregnant yet.
We feel it.
This one cannot walk past the store without buying her some kind of gift.
She's only carrying her baby.
Guys, you've got 9 months to overwhelm her with gratitude. Pace yourselves.
Hey, tell me if this is out of bounds. So it turns out Diane is a major Rocky Horror groupie. I'm gonna give her my friend poster.
You're giving that away?
Mm-hmm.
But that was like a shrine in your dorm room for 3 years. It used to creep me out.
Try losing your virginity under it. You're not creepy, honey.
What's up? Take it the Lindstroms didn't accept our offer.
How far apart are we?
I'm not sure that it's about zeros. He wants this place closed.
Thank you.
This egg just turned 40. Eggs that lie dormant for that many years begin to decay. Nothing stays the same forever.
Unless you're Goldie Hawn.
Your eggs may need a little boost, Ellen. Now, Dr. Campbell's done a procedure called a cytoplasmic transfer. Now, that's when an older egg is injected with a younger egg donor's cytoplasm. Now, the nucleus of your egg, which contains all of the DNA you're passing on to your child, is left untouched.
Ellen, think of it like this. We're going to save your yolk and get you a fresh egg white.
Look, I realize all this must seem like science fiction, but I also know how badly you and your husband want a child of your own.
Does any of this affect the baby?
Well, you tell me. This gorgeous little thing is going to turn 3 in May. Now, this procedure is how I helped her mother bring her into the world.
Why didn't you ever mention this before?
Because it's illegal.
And why would the FDA not approve the procedure?
Well, some people object because they feel that cytoplasmic transfer is too close to cloning.
Which it isn't.
And it's still too soon to know the long-term effects of the procedure.
And by the time they do clear it, you'll be dancing at your child's wedding.
So, by signing these, am I breaking the law?
You know what, Ellen? The truth is, doctors were prescribing antibiotics for stomach ulcers years before FDA approval. Botox was developed to help spastic eyelid blinking. Minoxidil, blood pressure. Most people use it to grow hair.
I'm just wondering.
There's nothing in there about the details of your procedure. No one has to know about the egg donor transfusion except for the people in this room.
And your husband.
And technically, he doesn't even need to know. You're my patient now, therefore entitled to confidentiality.
You know, why don't we go get a cup of coffee? This is a lot to absorb.
Ellen, you have my numbers. If you have any questions at all, you call me day or night, okay?
Okay. Oh, okay. Thank you.
Excuse me. You must be the Rachel that Malcolm never stops talking about. I'm Nora Campbell.
Oh, right. You're helping him with the gillies.
Yes.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Is there a ladies' room around here?
Oh, I'm heading in that direction.
Oh, great. I love your necklace. Is that jade?
And yes, it is. Thank you.
It's beautiful.
So Malcolm actually said something nice about me?
Oh, God, yes. He says you're the perfect combination plate. Beauty and brains and buoyancy.
Oh, well, I know he didn't say buoyancy, but thank you.
Yeah, okay, I added that, because you'd need it to be in business with him.
Oh, he's getting better. Look, he asked you for help on the Gilly case, so that makes him, what, half-human?
Yeah, I think he knows a little competition is a good thing. There were only two of us in our program, and he spent most of the first year trying to get rid of me.
Why?
Well, because when you're dealing with patients who can't get pregnant, most folks would rather talk to a doctor with a uterus.
There you are. You need to call Diane Bradford ASAP.
Excuse me. It's through that door on the right.
Great. Thank you. Hi.
Hi.
I love your earrings. Amethyst?
Plastic.
Hi, Marissa.
Oh, my God! There she is! Hero.
We're trying not to do baby talk.
Oh.
Is Scott around?
I think he's in his office.
Good. You're the one I need to see. We are having a crisis. I am freaking out because I'm running out of breast milk.
Shouldn't you be freaking out that you had any to begin with?
From our surrogate. She pumped for us, and I thought we had enough for like 3 months, but I went to the freezer, and we have 2 bags left. Scott won't let me ask her for more. I need your help.
What can I do?
You become best friends with every surrogate who walks in here. So what are they all doing with their extra milk?
Let me find out who's coming in today.
Okay. Hey, what are you guys doing here?
Oh, somebody wanted to come by and say hi to her papa.
You know, I'm not sure about the whole papa thing. It's still a little fiddler on the roof for me.
Oh, my God, we can't keep changing this on her. We decided I'm daddy, you're papa.
Well, good. If you like papa so much, I'll be daddy, you be papa.
Good news. I have a lead on someone who's still lactating.
You didn't.
Why? Why? Because I happen to care about the well-being of our child?
We talked about this for 3 hours last night, Jim. The doctor said formula was totally fine.
You know, I would ask your cousin in San Diego who just gave birth for some of her breast milk, but oh, no, wait, that's right. She doesn't know you're gay and have a child.
How are you able to work that into every argument?
Guys, don't fight about this. Please, let me just find her some breast milk. She is my goddaughter. I know that you're not doing that, but it's what I tell people.
Look, we're done discussing this. I have work to do. I love you. I tolerate you. I beg you to ignore him.
Hi, baby. Sorry.
Diane, I don't mean to pressure you. It's just that they're gonna be crushed.
Sorry. Let me call Suzanne and Dave.
No, don't. Let me speak to them first. Yeah, I'll call you later. Bye.
Somebody get cold feet?
Hey. Yeah, my best friend's surrogate. Her mother's ill, she has to go back east, and I basically just asked her when she expects her to croak.
Did she give you a date?
I gotta go meet my friends for lunch and drop the bomb. Welcome to the worst part of my job. Excuse me.
Yeah, sure.
Well, we met at my cousin's wedding. I was on the bride side, and he was crashing.
Hey, I thought it'd be a great place to pick up beautiful women. Boy, was I right.
So you have tried to get pregnant on your own for 2 years?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've been trying it backwards, forwards, in the pool.
Honey, I don't think that's what she asked.
No, it's good to know in case I'm ever invited to go swimming at your house.
We know that I'm the problem.
You learned this from your last doctor?
No, he wasn't very helpful. He said that we were still young and suggested that we just keep trying.
Yeah, we're not into the older parent thing. We'd like our child to be out of diapers before we start needing them ourselves.
Yeah.
Well, once you've met with Dr. Bowers and taken some tests...
We were hoping to just skip over some of that. We'd really like to look into your egg donors now.
One step at a time. Well, I need you to at least take a blood test before I can even begin to process your application.
Okay, a blood test, but he's not going to tell me anything I don't already know. Look, I have been poked and prodded like a lab rat. Please. I don't need another doctor telling me that this is my fault.
Asking you to stay.
Those cinnamon buns look good. Just because I'm not carrying the baby, I can still eat for 9 months, right?
Oh, man, the cravings are already starting. Do you want one, Rach?
Oh, no, thank you.
Oh, look at those cheeks.
Hey, do you want to go somewhere else to eat? Somewhere quiet.
I love it here. You know, it's the first time we've been able to come for about 2 years.
Oh, hi.
Dave and I used to get so depressed because there's so many babies and strollers, and I would look around at all these mommies and daddies and just hate them because it was so easy for them.
Suzanne, when Dave comes back...
He would never admit this, but it's been killing him, too. I mean, the last 4 years, sex has been like this horrible job. Honestly, I'm not sure the marriage was able to take much more.
Hey, Yon, still warm.
Thank you.
What's the matter, Rach?
Guys, we've got a problem. I got a phone call from Diane this morning.
What's the matter?
Her mom's ill. She has to go back east to take care of her.
We're doing the transfer next week.
How long?
She doesn't know. It might be a while. Listen to me. It is a setback. But I'll find you someone else.
This isn't happening.
At the most, it'll be 6 months.
6 months?
And then what about the next one? What if she decides she'd rather take a vacation or she doesn't want to get stretch marks? 4 years of fertility treatments and 2 adoptions falling through. We named the last one. And then we show up at the hospital and they tell us she's going to keep him.
Hey, Suzanne.
I know. I'm sorry. It's not you. I'm just... I'm done.
No. No,
yeah,
no,
I'm done.
I can...
We're through counting on strangers to make us a family.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Oh, just curious, why did you rush the Marek's blood test results?
I don't know. It was just something about them. One minute they're talking about having sex in their pool, next minute they want to see egg donors. Why? What'd you find?
Well, her blood tested positive for Nara syndrome. This needs dressing. My guess is that she's not being completely honest.
About what?
That she's taking the pill. You might want to find a way to break it to Mr. Merrick, but his wife is doing everything in her power not to have a baby.
Feeding these squirrels. I guess some people just think they're reincarnated mean people, but I like them. When I first moved out here, I had this landlord. He used to shellac rodents. I mean, he wouldn't kill them or anything. He'd just scoop up the ones that were already dead. I was actually kind of all right with it until one year he used all of them to make this nativity scene. Oh, no, wait. No, I'm not a weirdo or anything. I promise. I just wanted to buy your breast milk.
Doing everything by halves. Excuse me.
Here to see Bowers.
And your name is?
We met yesterday. Has Mrs. Gilley returned her paperwork?
I don't know.
Stay on that for me, will you, Patrice? See? I remember yours. It's complicated. This time
I think it could be. So the Lindstrom's lawyer keeps calling, guys. It's our move.
Why aren't we letting insurance take care of this?
Because if we do, our new premiums will close this place faster than Lindstrom. We need to make an appointment with a loan officer.
No, I'm not putting this place in debt. I'd rather go to trial.
No jury would side with us.
Why not? In 3 years, we've helped hundreds of families. If they weigh that against this one case...
And those sobbing clients sit there, childless, Mrs. Lindstrom in a veil, knitting black booties. No, Scott, you need to settle this.
I don't know that it's about the money.
You know what? Try playing offense for a change. What do you tell the Lindstroms? That if this goes to trial, every detail of their non-productive sex life will be paraded before a jury. Are they up for that?
I am not taking birth control.
Joanne, it showed up on the blood test.
Fine. Fine, maybe there's a reason I don't want to use my own eggs.
That's okay. Clients come in all the time with family histories of alcoholism or mental illness. It's more common than you think. But you've got to be honest with me and with your husband.
No, telling my husband is not an option, okay? Thank you for your time. Obviously, I need to go to another clinic.
You can hit every clinic in this city, but no one is going to help you bring a child into a marriage that's based on a lie.
There's no lie, okay? My life began when I met Sam. Who he married is not the person I was before that.
Why?
Here, why don't I just spell it out for you, okay? See, nose job, chin job, boob job, liposuction, dermabrasion, electrolysis. Should I keep going?
I think I get it.
Do you? Do you really get it? Were you teased and tortured every day of your life? How many dogfight parties were you invited to and then humiliated and left to walk home alone? There's no way in hell that you or anybody else is going to convince me that I need to put my child through that. I will start a family, and I will do it on my terms, not yours.
Thank you.
Hello, Patrice.
Yeah.
So when'd you stop doing the nurse?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Please, I know that look. I've gotten it. I've given it.
Look, isn't there some antelope you got to go kill for your lunch?
No, I'm actually off meat today. Do you want to go grab a salad?
No, thank you. But I will see you out.
Well, if it's about money, I'll buy. I mean, I don't want to spend your last dollar.
All right, Miss Gossip, who told you about the lawsuit? Hmm?
Well, it's not exactly a secret, Bowers. I mean, your employees are lining up to fax their resumes.
Well, I prefer to see the glasses half full.
Well, it better be full of scotch, because from what I can see, the doors of this place could be closing soon.
Thankfully, none of your concern.
Mrs. Gilly is, and if we don't hurry, we'll be doing the transfer out of the trunk of your car.
Family options.
Hi, hey, I got your message. So, did you find someone to get us some breast milk?
Yes, I think I did. And only 4 easy payments.
Miss America's scheduled to come in on Friday to give a sample.
Well, we'll just call him and tell him we're canceling.
Wait, wait, wait. If we turn away someone based on a disability...
Excuse me. Since when is butt ugly a disability?
A judge might see it that way.
No lawyer would ever take that case.
Why not? It's been scientifically proven that attractive people have an easier time in life.
Malcolm.
Oh, you don't think your looks have opened doors for you? Try walking into a restaurant when you're 80 pounds overweight. Enjoy eating behind a plant.
She wants us to help her design a baby. I have a problem with that.
Tell me, how do we reject one client who wants a beautiful child and then embrace another who demands a donor with high SAT scores?
This client is perfectly healthy.
Guys, we're designing babies here every day to some degree. You can't just jump on your high horses because a woman tells you she had an extreme makeover. I could just as easily argue she'd make a good mother because she's trying to protect her child from unnecessary anguish.
This mother needs parenting herself.
If she came clean to the husband, would that sway popular opinion? Rachel?
I don't know what to say, Malcolm. I'm banging my head against a wall trying to help my best friend start a family, and we're debating someone who doesn't want her kid to have big ears and buck teeth. I mean, maybe I just don't get it. I thought we started this place so that we can help people who can't conceive. Not for those who can, but won't.
Why don't you take a peek at this?
What am I looking at here?
My schedule. 3 cancellations already this week. I'm assuming we can thank the Lindstrom lawsuit for that. So go ahead. Let's keep picking and choosing. Maybe we can reject the next client because we don't like her shoes.
So, I discussed your situation with my colleagues.
What did you tell them? Everything? Is Dr. Bowers willing to work with me?
He might be. But let me ask you something. Since you are so determined to use a donor and not tell your husband, have you thought about what you're going to tell your child?
What's there to tell?
Your child
will look like the donor, who will look like I do now.
Remember that old commercial where they try to fool Mother Nature? They give her margarine and tell her that it's butter. She'd lose her temper and lightning would strike the tree she's under.
I'm sorry, what made you think of this?
I don't know. I guess just the idea that we think we can go cruising through life, fooling the people we love without paying the price. Something tells me that if you pack on too many lies, you won't have a tree to stand under. Joanne, that lightning bolt is headed straight for you.
What is that?
That's a check. Hopefully, it's enough to make Mr. Lindstrom go away. Forever.
Nora, we're not looking for private investors.
Oh, I see. So you'd rather pay interest on a bank loan? Come on, don't make this about pride, guys. That money would free you up to do the work that you need to do, and frankly, I won't miss it.
We can't accept this. It would take us years to pay you back.
Oh, I'm not looking for reimbursement. I was thinking that maybe I could be part of the clinic. No title or anything, just a silent partner.
Have you two already discussed this?
No, this is my shocked face. Why are you doing this, Nora?
Because when I was in your clinic, I saw wall after wall paved with baby pictures. Now, you two are helping hundreds of people realize their dreams, and there are a hell of a lot more people out there that need you.
Okay, so what do you really want?
What? Exactly what I said. I'd like to be back in the game.
Nora.
Malcolm. Seriously. It'd be nice to see a few patients every now and then. I miss the thrill of telling someone they're knocked up.
Oh, cut the crap. Are you really hoping to take something away from me?
Actually, I was hoping that we could rekindle some of the magic that we had when we used to work side by side. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
How was breakfast?
Expensive. Any messages?
No.
Thanks.
Oh, wait. You also got this.
Oh. What's that sound?
What? Oh, that. I'm trying to stimulate my breasts.
Hey, Lenny just told me we settled the Lindstrom case.
I heard that Nora person wrote them a fat check.
Hey, wait. She looks like that and she's rich?
Yeah, you didn't hear it from me, but a friend of mine used to work with her at the hospital, and she said that Nora won a huge lawsuit.
I heard she got sued.
No. She turned around, and she sued them for suing her or something.
So what, does she own this place now?
Yeah, wait, do we work for her now?
Red or white?
I'm easy.
Yeah. What about you? Honey. Suzanne. Red or white?
You choose. Whatever.
Listen, I know we promised not to talk about this tonight, but I found you a wonderful surrogate.
No. Stop. We can't do this again.
I promise you can trust this one.
Who is she?
Me. I want to carry your baby for you.
I'll give you a minute.
You know, you didn't have to do this. I hate pulling you away from the baby.
Please, Rose is asleep. You're pulling me away from Jim, which is fine. He's baby-proofing our bathrooms. I can't open a single toilet.
Scott, how long did it take you to decide that you wanted Nina to be your surrogate?
How long? We told her we wanted her before she ordered dessert. Why?
I offered to carry Suzanne and Dave's baby.
What did they say?
Well, they said they had to think about it. And then it got really weird.
How did this happen?
I spent the last 2 days calling everyone. No one's available. And then I thought, well, why shouldn't it be me? I spend every day counseling surrogates. I loved being pregnant. I mean, if Suzanne were my sister, I wouldn't think twice about it.
Yeah, but it's a huge leap from wanting people you love to become parents to carrying their baby. I think your relationship's weird now. Wait till you get inside their marriage. It's gonna happen.
I know, I thought about all that, but I just hate the idea that they're giving up. They're the ones that convinced me to have Noah. I wanna do this for them. While I breathe.
Give them some time. It's the only decision they get to make, Rach. For the next 9 months, you hold all the cards.
Just don't know. Okay, you got your television here, remote on top, pornos down here, magazines below. When you're done, take the cup, stick it in the slot, and give me a shout. Don't be a hero.
Joanne's mother.
Come on, Joanne. Come on, Joanne. Put your hand down.
Dad, turn it off.
Put this in there. Lydia, we won't, we're not going to be seeing the doctor next week. Joanne and I, well, I guess we need to talk about some things. Go on a first date.
Oh. I'm gonna give these Valium to Mrs. Rafferty for a transfer.
Scott, I'm glad you're here. Do you know how to make fresh coffee?
Sure. Let me roll up my law degree from Columbia and use it as a filter. So, Mrs. Skilly just dropped off her consent forms.
Oh, good.
Yeah, she was acting pretty weird, making excuses about the Reverend's signature. Couldn't look me in the eye, only wanted to give the forms back to you.
Well, she's tense, you know. As long as the forms are signed, you needn't worry.
Malcolm, I've just spent the past 2 weeks defending this place. We can't start booking clients on hushed-up procedures.
Scott, this isn't a legal matter.
Hey, you don't work in a vacuum. What you do affects all of us, and if you think we can ride out another scandal, you're way off base. Okay, forget about us. What are you gonna do? Go work for a hospital? You can't work for anyone else. If this place crumbles, you're as screwed as the rest of us.
Still hooked on this game, huh? I thought you left that country in pursuit of life and liberty and sunlight.
I was gonna call you when I got home.
After you downed 6 pints with your mates. Come on, you can't be that scared of me.
I'm entitled to change my mind.
And cancel a procedure that I'm performing? No, you're not my boss.
And you're certainly not mine. Look, Nora, this may surprise you, but I actually care about these people. The Gillies are both my patients, and the Reverend never signed those consent forms.
We've been over this. He doesn't have to.
This is his wife, Nora. He's a deeply spiritual man who's been suspicious and uncomfortable since his first visit to the clinic.
Yet he's been through 4 failed transfers. Now, whether the congregation approves or not, the dear Reverend is operating under a don't ask, don't tell policy.
Yeah, well, I can't. Sometimes someone has to use the brakes.
Why? What did you take a poll or something? Did you ask your congressman, your cleaning lady? Who is it exactly that's sitting on this ethics committee of yours?
It's not a committee, Nora. It's called me and my staff. If this clinic crumbles, then the rest of us can't retreat back to the family ranch in Texas. I didn't say it could never happen. It just can't happen at my clinic. Okay?
Okay, stop. Our clinic. I didn't write a check so I could buy into some spineless bureaucracy. That's called a hospital.
You know what, Nora? We'll pay you the money back. Within
time. This isn't about money, Bowers. This is about us using every resource we have to help a patient. If we waited for the church and the legislature to catch up to science, this woman wouldn't be pregnant till she was 70. I wrote you that check? I wrote it because I thought you were someone who didn't ask for permission. But no, evidently now, since we have our Italian suits and our $200 haircut and our trophy house on the hill, all that's changed. What a waste. You actually used to challenge me.
He asked you to wear this?
No, I swear, I did it on my own. But I wore it for 2 days and nothing would come out of me. But I did talk to this nutritionist in Venice who said that if I drank this tea that's made
Marissa,
from...
Marissa, it's not your job to supply us with milk.
No, I'm doing it for Rose, because babies need
this. She has everything she needs. What I mean is, we want you to be a huge part of Rose's life, but you don't need to solve every problem.
No, you guys are my closest friends.
I know, sweetie, but it took so many people just to bring this baby into the world.
Yeah, but that's okay. It takes a village.
It does, but right now I think Jim and I need to close our gates. Look, we love you, Marissa, but we have to be able to do this by ourselves. Okay? Why don't you come by on Saturday, huh? I'm sure Rose would love to see your godmother.
Good night.
Hey, who is this door?
Our neighborhood milkmaid.
Oh, like somebody's hungry. I'm just gonna go mix up some of their formula.
Hey there. Did you hear back from Dave and Suzanne?
No.
Well, whether this happens or not, they are damn lucky to have you in their lives.
Oh, thank you. I'll see you Monday.
Call me if you need to talk.
Bowers here.
Mr. Lindstrom, I think he's gone for the day. Can I help you?
No, unless you can bring back my wife.
Sir, what did you say?
My wife. She left for good.
Sorry, I didn't know that. I heard the case was settled.
Yeah, I won. Really won, didn't I?
Mr. Lindstrom, you and your wife have gone through an extraordinary...
You're not hearing me. This place cost me my marriage.
I think some of those issues were already at the core.
I didn't come here for counseling.
What did you come here for?
I guess... I thought somebody here might finally take some responsibility for this.
We won't be coming back tonight. Friday is rugby. After that, the team hangs out and they go to this trashy bar.
Would you hand me a 3037 dish?
What exactly am I hanging around here for? No, it is the weekend.
And some of us do have plans.
Fine, go. But first, can you pull a specimen from the cryo tank, number 178? Reverend Gilly's sample, please.
You were alone. Didn't realize you asked Patrice to stay.
Just till you got here. Thanks for your help, Patrice. Have a nice weekend.
I could stay.
You heard her. Have a nice weekend.
So, what are you doing for the next 9 months?
Better get down some glasses, because this is the last night you can get smashed.
Face, I think you would kind of look like mine. If it had a home, would it be nice? Would you believe me if I said I'm tired of this? Well, here we go now, one more time. I try to climb your steps, I try to chase you down, I try to see how low I can get down to the ground. I try to earn my way, I try to tame this mind. You better believe that I have tried to beat this. So where will this end? It goes on and on.
Get that?
Oh, let the machine get it.